Regardless of your preferred slicer, we're going to show you the two most famous slicing softwares for resin 3D printing to facilitate your printing experience. Hey guys, how are you? My name is Julia, and in this video, we will show you how to use the two main programs that add supports and slicing parts to 3D printing. Chitubox is a widely known program and we use it for some functions in the process of validation the printed pieces here at LUT, while Lychee has been acquiring many new users with features that help the dynamics of file preparation. Regardless of your preference, it's interesting to experiment and learn the basics of slicing programs like these two that we'll show, so you can create a work process best suited for your needs. But you already know that here at LUT, we deliver all the parts already pre-supported with the STL model, hollow and solid, and even the project where you can make modifications. In addition, the models go through a validation process where the pieces are printed until perfection is reached. And so, you ask me, why do I need to know how to use these programs if LUT has already done this work for me? Well, we're going to introduce the steps related to the settings so you can choose to perform the slicing of the part and take the file to the printer. But enough talk, and let's go straight to the computer screen. We will show you each step in both programs so we can understand that basically we have the same functions but in different positions to access them. Also, we will use the latest version of Chitubox 1.9.0 and that of Lychee 3.5.1. As every program, there's an option menu where you can import, export, access the program setting and other options that are on the upper left. When importing STL files in both programs, we can use the basic option for moving the part art, which in both programs is on the left side of the screen. It's where it's possible to move along the XYZ axis and rotate the part at its specific angles. Also, we have the possibility to align one face of the part in relation to the printer's platform, scale proportionally or individually each axis and mirror in one of the three axes. To make copies of a piece, you can use the famous Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V in Chitubox or an icon on the top bar that allows you to copy and another one to automatically realign the models. While in Lychee, it's only possible to duplicate using the copy button and the same icon on the left of this homepage. It's possible to move your camera view using the mouse, the right and the central buttons and the scroll wheel. In the upper right corner, you can see in both programs a cube that represents the positioning. This allows you to modify the view in order to align the screen regarding the faces. To configure a new printer with Chitubox, it's necessary to click on Settings on the right side, which will open a new tab. In the upper left corner, it's possible to see a list where you can find almost every printer on the market with the correct settings for the selected one. In Lychee, the button to add and configure the printer in Resin is in the upper left corner. Although the interface is different, the function is the same, with a few differences. There are other buttons, but it's always good to explore the program on your own and get a little familiarity. In Chitubox, if you hover your mouse over somewhere, it shows you with visual examples what each function does. This allows you to better understand each setting, especially in this next tab that we will show you. To assess the next step, which would be the supports, you can go to Chitubox in the upper right corner where there is an icon of a piece supported by three pillars. In Lychee, this parameter is at the top right in the center, on the Prepare button. Creating support may seem easy, as even the program can automatically create supports for your part. But achieving success still depends on how you configure these automatic parameters, because it's not always a 100% satisfactory result. That's why, at LUT, we will always find tested parts, made entirely by hand by our team. Exclusively in both programs, we can have pre-selected configurations for light, medium and heavy types of support. Also, we can individually configure the raft part, which is the form of contact between the support and the platform. The base, the middle, and the tip of the pillar, with numerous options, may seem confusing at first, but with practice and a little knowledge, it's possible to sail through. But in this video, we won't show all these settings in depth. The option that generates a distance of the piece regarding the platform in the Chitubox is right below the support icon, with Z lift height written. As a default, we use 5mm here at root. The same option is on the last utilities icons on the second settings window, in the lower right corner of the Lychee program. In this supports tab, it's possible with a bar on the right corner to view layer by layer, which allows you to view more hiding points and identify areas that need more support contacts. In addition, both programs generate a visualization identified by colors, showing the angle that parts of the 3D model have in relation to the platform, which facilitates the understanding of where to place or not the supports. One of the most recent options in the programs when placing supports is the search and visualization of islands, identified by the program itself. This feature can be done in Lychee in real time with an interface that indicates with red dots the areas with islands where it's necessary to add a contact with support. In Chitubox, the option in real time is only possible in the Pro version, but in the basic version, after the next slicing step that we will talk about next, it's possible to search automatically for islands where should be supported but aren't, according to the program's intelligence. We already provide both hollow and solid parts, but if you want to make some parts hollow, you can do this in both programs, with a little difference between them. In Chitubox, the option to make the part hollow is on the initial screen, in the icons on the top bar and right beside the option to create holes that serves as drainage and suction relief. In Lychee, this option is in the brackets preparation window, in an icon on the left of the screen, but the holes are only created virtually, being a kind of pixel blocking and not a physical interference in your model. This way, if you save a hollow part in STL with the Lychee hole, your part will still have no holes when opening in other program. Another difference in this option is how the internal mesh of the hollow object is generated, as the smoother with all details and angles that need support, the better it is to print. If you have modified something and want to save your file, you can do this with each model individually or all together as STL or as a scene that includes the whole project with the possibility to modify later. In Chitubox, these options are found in that program menu where in Import, Save and Open Program Settings. Meanwhile, in Lychee, this option is in two places on the last tab by clicking on the last button at the top of the screen and also on the File button. There, you can save files and projects in the same way as Chitubox. Finally, we have the slicing part, which creates the printer-specific reading file that will cure the resin in each layer of the 3D model. This process mainly depends on the UV light exposure settings chosen and the layer height that we've already shown in the last two videos in this series. Once configured in Chitubox, just press Slice and wait for the program to generate your printer's reading file. In Lychee, it's necessary to go to the last Export tab, where you can generate the slice clicking on the Export Slices button. Wait for the program to generate the file to be able to save it on a pen drive and take it to your printer. But when you get to your printer, how are you going to know how much resin to put in? Most printers have maximum level gauges and indicators, but sometimes, with a very large part, it's necessary to replenish the resin level during printing. For this, the program gives you a very close estimate of the resin used for the pieces and the estimated time to finish printing, but it's worth knowing that there is a minimum amount of resin needed to fill the vat tank and guarantee the printing process, because in the up and down movement, the liquid resin from the tank must flow under the part so that the next layer is made. So, we must work with a safety margin. For example, if the tank holds 250 milliliters and the minimum is 50 milliliters, we can try to work with 80 to 100 milliliters left over to avoid unnecessary failures. So it's possible to calculate and predict the need to add more resin during printing. Now, abundance function that exists in Lychee is updated in the file, where it's possible to make some physical change to the 3D model in another program, such as thickening thin parts or modifying the mesh quality, also without losing the position of the previously generated supports. This is a feature that in order to work, you need to be careful with the position and the type of modification, as some bizarre errors can occur, but still very useful. There are many other programs to perform similar slicing functions, but little by little we'll delve into specific points that you find most interesting. We hope that this video, as introductory as it is, has served to learn a little more about resin 3D printing process. And that's why we would very much like your opinion in the comments. What other topics would be more relevant to help clarify most pertinent doubts? And I know you don't want to miss the next video, where we'll be talking about how can we increase the scales of Lutz models without compromising the supports and still managing to save a little material? Bye bye! See you at the next video!